a lot of hockey players look to me to get better at their sport. What they don't realize is that the answer already lies within them. Look, if you're an average person who puts an average amount of effort with an average amount of discipline and an average amount of consistency, you need to stop expecting above average results. You're going to have to start getting comfortable with being uncomfortable. The body isn't going to change unless you give it a reason to. There are no magic bullets in the sport of hockey. If you want the speed that kills, if you want the strength that makes it impossible to knock you off the puck, if you want that elite level conditioning that guarantees that you are on fire all game long, and if you just want to become a better all-round hockey player than you have ever been before, then you're going to need to take things to a level that you haven't been willing to go to yet. You may have a lot of support around you, or you may have no support around you. It doesn't matter, because at the end of the day, you are the only one who can gauge the amount of effort that you are putting in per day, every single day, to become a better hockey player. And it all begins with your mindset. The mind often tells you one thing, while the body will tell you another. But if you lead with the mind, the body is forced to follow. And it all starts with discipline. You need to start relying on your self-discipline and leave willpower at the door. Willpower is a self-defeating tactic. It's a resource that can be depleted, and it locks your mindset to the idea that your environment is acting on you. Whereas self-discipline is a function of choice that can never be depleted, as it comes from within. Self-discipline allows you to think clearly because now you're acting on your environment instead of your environment acting on you. Willpower magnifies your current circumstance, whereas self-discipline magnifies your character. Willpower will never lead to the development of self-discipline, while the development of self-discipline makes willpower irrelevant. Willpower is draining. Self-discipline is sustainable. Self-discipline represents that no matter what your current circumstance is, you determine your choices, and therefore you determine your environment. You have to change your thinking to change your hockey performance. I have never met a hockey player who wasn't successful, but who is also very self-disciplined. On the other hand, I have met a ton of hockey players who could have had great potential in this sport if they only had some discipline to back up their talent. Discipline is the bridge you need to walk through to get to the other side of your hockey potential. Don't train to hit a quota. Train to reach your potential. And for God's sakes, if a hockey athlete is doing better than you right now, the worst thing that you can possibly do is call them lucky. Circumstance doesn't change the standard. No matter where you started, it doesn't change where the finish line is. So nobody wants to hear your sob story about your current circumstance or your genetics. Look, I don't know you, but if you're like most people I meet, you have hockey aspirations in your life. Those aspirations can include everything from just making the local team to going all the way to the NHL. The specifics of your hockey aspirations are irrelevant, and your entire dream can be as well if you keep delaying the action of becoming more disciplined and deciding instead to sit back and call others lucky. We all do an amazing job at sabotaging ourselves with excuses and reasons why things don't happen and why things can never happen. Normally, this comes in the form of tricking ourselves that it'll happen soon. I'll get serious soon. I'll try harder soon. Soon being starting tomorrow, next week, next month, when I get time, when things calm down at work, or as soon as I have the money to. These abstract moments never arrive, but we trick ourselves into feeling excited as if they're right around the corner. In my experience as a coach watching hundreds of people progress in my life, you just need to shut up and start. No more soon and no more delays. Just start. The only thing worse than changing your current routine is not changing your current routine. You have to get out of this and start acting the way you talk. Whatever ideas you have about becoming a better hockey player are useless until you marry them to execution. Your success isn't about an idea. It's realizing that you are the executioner. People accomplish amazing things every single day, almost never because of luck. It becomes two things: prioritize and execute. Prioritize and execute. That's what I want you to say to yourself every single day when you wake up. I want you to look at your list of to-dos and then prioritize and execute them. No questions asked, like a real disciplined hockey player who won't take no for an answer. When you see other hockey players doing great things, you have two choices. Number one, you can drown in envy and justify why it can't be you. Or number two, you can see their accomplishments as evidence that success in hockey is something you can reach as well. When you start moving, you will quickly realize that your limitations and ideas of impossibility will begin to fade. You don't even know what to do in order to start moving. Just start. Change happens in your mind before it enters the world, and belief will always precede progress. Become disciplined, and you will become a better hockey player.